All right, so let's talk about the Galaxy S22 Ultra. But I think it pays to get some perspective first, so let's back up a little and see where it all started. Samsung announced the Galaxy S series back in 2010. It was all you could have wanted from an iPhone plus more. In fact, it was the thinnest phone ever made. Powerful phone with 8 to 16 gigabytes of storage. Plus a micro SD slot that could support up to 32 gigabytes of storage. Super AMOLED display. Front and rear facing cameras. Of course, this sounds very funny to say now, but for example, iPhone 4, which was released in the same year, was the first iPhone that had both front and rear facing cameras. Anyways, the launch was a success, and a year later in 2011, we saw the release of Galaxy S2, which was obviously better than the Galaxy S. But in the same year, Samsung released the first Galaxy Note, which was even more powerful than the Galaxy S2. It also had a bigger battery because of the size of the phone. But something funny happened. Many criticized Samsung that because of its size, this is an unusable phone. In fact, take this. Samsung's slogan was phone, tablet, feel free, it's Galaxy Note. And then eventually everybody called it a phablet. Little did we know this possibly set the standard for all the huge phones that we have today. Now fast forward to almost a decade later, people buy Galaxy Note phones mainly for three reasons. First, no matter what Galaxy S flagship is released by Samsung, the Galaxy Note phones, which are always released after the S series, are more capable and powerful. Secondly, they've got a big screen, and finally, they've got a pen inside, so they're great for productivity. But what happened is that in 2021, Samsung officially killed the Note line. The end of an era. And then again, in 2022, just about a week ago, we saw this. So yeah, the Note is back. Well, kind of. You see, this is just like killing a superhero in a movie and then bringing it back in an unexpected way in the next sequel. Except many people already knew about the fact that Samsung's marrying the Note and S series. You know, if we take a look at the design of this phone, we can see that it has more of a squared off design, just like the Note line does. Or did. Which again makes sense because like I said, the Note series was always superior to the S series. So this marriage and this new look with the less protruding camera bumps and obviously an S Pen inside are so exciting to so many people that Samsung thinks the demand is going to be so high that they're probably going to run out of stock very quickly. And this is mostly going to be the case, especially with the chip shortage that we're dealing with right now. And this might have been the reason why Samsung released the S21 FE so late. What's not so exciting though is that pretty much everyone wants a micro SD slot on this phone, and Samsung just doesn't listen. The other thing is that the camera hardware hasn't increased since the S21 Ultra, although we've been hearing from all the leaks and probably soon during the launch that there have been so much software optimization that we're gonna see better pictures and videos, especially in low light. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I think this is a very interesting launch and the announcement is gonna happen on February 9th, so subscribe and hit the notification bell so if you missed the live event, you can watch the recap afterwards in my channel. So try to stay in the loop, subscribe and like the video, and I'll see you in the next one. I wanna be the best in the game, invest in my name, check no restraints, I'm obsessed with the pain, I ingest, I retain.